Welcome to American Spectrum. I am your host, Ali Waris. This is part three of our series on the Pennsylvania's judicial underworld. The last episode was about the federal courthouse in Philadelphia. Today, we will continue with the same, and you will see a lot more about the activities of this courthouse. You will see there is much evidence of a calculated and systematic assault on the rule of law by these judges and a noticeable erosion of the long-cherished, time-honored American values. Stay with us if you can. In our public accountability hearing today, we will be talking to U.S. Attorney General Eric Holder, the U.S. Senate Judiciary Committee Chairman Senator Patrick Leahy, and the U.S. Court of Appeals for the Third Circuit Chief Judge, the Honorable Theodore McKee. We will be talking to these officials all at the same time, because the issues under discussion are interwoven and relate to each of these gentlemen. Senator Leahy, General Holder, and Chief Judge McKee, welcome to American Spectrum's public accountability hearing. So that you know, in this session today, I will be asking several questions and making some statements under oath. On this 28th day of May 2011, I, Ali Waris, verify under the penalty of perjury that the following statements under oath, as stated here, are materially and substantially true to the best of my knowledge, information, and belief. I understand that any false statement purported herein as a statement under oath is subject to the penalties of 18 Pennsylvania Criminal Statute Section 4904 relating to the unsworn falsification to authorities. So, help me God. Good day, Senator Leahy. We the people, under the jurisdiction of the U.S. Court of Appeals for the Third Circuit, would like to know why we are being shortchanged by your Judiciary Committee when it comes to the appointment of federal judges for this area. Sir, we had taken it for granted that the judges appointed to the federal bench in Philadelphia would have certain qualifications that would enrich the federal judiciary with quality intellect and which in turn would strengthen our democracy. But that is not what is happening. Despite the fact that our area has some of the best legal minds in the nation, we have to settle with the bottom of the barrel when it comes to the appointment to the federal bench. Part 2 of this series provides a sample of quality of the judges that were imposed on us and for which we will be paying a price for many years to come. Also in that episode, we demonstrated that to your former colleague, Senator Arlen Specter, the only criteria for the federal bench was the candidate's loyalty to him and to the Israeli agenda. So the second issue that concerns us is the cover-up. Senator, we would like to know why we cannot get anyone's attention over the possible criminal subversion of the Senate judiciary proceedings by the District Judge Michael Bailson and the Appeals Court Judge Marjorie Rendell, as described in Part 2 of the series. There is overwhelming evidence that in conspiracy with the FBI, these two judges hid major flaws of their background. Senator, I state under the penalty of perjury that on 3 separate complaints against Judge Michael Bailson's possible criminal subversion of his Senate confirmation proceedings, the Third Circuit Court of Appeals covered up the complaints. The appeals court judges went out of their way to suppress the issue. Senator, unless we are assured that Bailson's record is clean, we must assume that he is an imposter judge who failed to pass the muster of his confirmation hearings. He does not meet the conditions of Article 3 of the U.S. Constitution, and thereby he should not be making any decisions as a judge, much less life and death decisions. Senator, given that last December, Louisiana Federal Judge Thomas Porteous was impeached by the Senate for hiding his past under the penalty of perjury, is it true that Judge Bailson has been spared an investigation because of his proximate ties with the Israeli lobby? Sir, we would like to hear from you. The third issue is that of the Judicial Misconduct Act. Mr. Chairman, as you know, that judicial misconduct among the federal judges has reached a pandemic stage with no relief in sight. The Judicial Conduct and Disability Act of 2008 has become a joke across the nation. The appeals court judges routinely cover up the misconduct of fellow judges by falsely holding misconduct complaint as frivolous. They routinely lie and cheat. Could you please tell us why there is no ongoing review on the effectiveness of the Judicial Conduct and Disability Act? Would like to hear from you on this issue as well. Thank you, Senator. General Holder, I would like to ask you about a very disturbing pattern which strongly indicates that the U.S. Department of Justice is controlled by the State of Israel. And here are some examples. Recently, Congresswoman Jane Herman of California was caught by the FBI helping the Israeli spies. Jane Herman's recorded conversation were the basis of a case of criminal violation against our national security. But your department decided not to indict her. The Bush administration gave a very stupid explanation, which was that the Republicans needed her political support on certain issues. They needed an unindicted criminal for political support. Basically, that's what they were saying. Then in three separate cases, Israeli spies on United States were indicted and convicted. But they did not do any prison time because their cases were steered by your lawyers to the pro-Israeli federal judges. When they were freed without a single day in prison, your department did not appeal their sentencing. Sir, you don't think that 23 years of passing America's secrets to foreign country was bad enough for you not to let these traitors get off the hook? Your department appeals light sentencing all the time. Could you please tell us why you never appealed the sentencing of the Israeli spies? It seems that the department has many lawyers working as the foot soldiers of the Israeli lobby, and they have the capability of steering certain cases to pro-Israeli federal judges for the outcome that they want. General Holder, I look forward to receiving your explanation. Thank you, sir. Chief Judge McKee, I just have one request, and that is please admit that you have made false statement. You have written frivolous opinion to protect Judge Michael Bailson and Judge Marvin Katz and other judges who are the foot soldiers of Israeli lobby. You, Judge Sloviter, and Judge Srika have made false statements, and I have said that under oath, so you either get me indicted or you admit it. Thank you, Your Honor. Thank you, sir. Part 4 of this series is on the nuts and bolts of judicial corruption. See you next time.